is another good exercise for new mothers. Stand with your legs together and your arms overhead. Bend your knees and turn your torso to the right. And touch the outside of your right knee with both hands. Return to the starting position and repeat 10 times, alternating right and left. Take this one nice and easy. That's it. Very good. This exercise will help you eliminate bloating. Begin with your weight on the right leg, your left leg pointed out and both arms extended to the right. Now, bring your left knee up and cross it to the right. At the same time, swing both arms down toward your left hip. Returning to the starting position, count off 8 with each leg. That's it. Keep those arms moving. And reverse. Try to get that knee way up. With your weight on your right leg, your left knee bent and turn to the side with the weight on the toes. Place your left hand on your hip and your right arm at your side. Keeping the knee turned out, raise your left leg as high as possible. At the same time, extend your right arm up and lean toward the right. Return to the starting position and repeat 8 times with each leg. That's it. Really stretch out. And now the other way. Here you're working all 4 sets of abdominal muscles. Tightening these muscles really flattens the stomach. Standing straight with your feet wide apart, bend your right foot up and back, and at the same time, swing both arms up and to the left. Lunge to the right side with your right foot, and swing both arms to the right. Repeat 8 times to the right and 8 times to the left. That's it. Good, steady motion. And reverse. Here you're flattening your stomach and firming your thighs. For any exercise that requires kneeling, sitting, or lying on the floor, do the exercise on a mat, a thick carpet, or a folded towel. Sitting on the floor with your legs apart, extend your arms out to the side. Raise your right leg and swing it across to the left side. Touch your right ankle with your left hand. Cross kick 8 times with each leg. Pull tight and stretch. This exercise really works the lower stomach. feet wide apart and flat on the floor. Raise your arms in front of you. Kick your right leg straight out to the side, and at the same time, swing both arms to the left. Side kick 8 times with each leg. Really swing that leg out low. Work that stomach. Sit on the floor with your left leg bent in and your right leg extended forward. Hold your ankles with both hands. Now, keeping your foot flat, raise your right leg and swing it to the side. Then lower to the floor. Lift the leg and return it to the starting position. Side lift 8 times with each leg. That's it. Nice, easy motion. Now the other leg. This is also a good postnatal exercise. Very good. Move into a hurdler's position with the left leg back and the right leg extended to the side. Raise your right leg and circle it 10 times. Reverse your leg position and circle the left leg 10 times. Here you're working the transverse muscles that crisscross the stomach. Tightening these muscles really flattens the stomach. Keep it going. And relax. Sit on the floor with your legs extended forward, toes up, and your hands at your sides. Lift your hips and pull in your stomach. Hold for 5 counts. Then return to the starting position. Lift up 5 times, making sure you lift your hips straight up off the floor. Slowly lift up. This exercise will help relieve menstrual cramps. Lie on your back with your head off the floor. Hold your elbows in your hands. Cross the right leg over the left so that your right foot is flat on the floor. Keeping your legs in position, sit up and twist your folded arms to the right. Do this 8 times, then switch positions and do 8 more. Take this one nice and easy. And now the other way. This one's a real stomach flattener. on your right side, allow your weight to rest on your elbow. Place your left hand on your hip. Keeping your foot flat, not pointed, raise your leg as high as possible. Now, lower to the resting position and repeat 10 times on each side. This is a great workout for the waistline. And now the other way. Keep that foot flat out. And slowly back. Sitting with your weight on your elbows, bend your knees in toward your chest. Extend both legs up and to the right. Bend your knees in toward your chest. Then extend your legs toward the left, alternating your left and right. Repeat 15 times. Nice steady motion. You're working your hips, legs, and stomach. Now that you've completed the workout, begin your cool down here. Lying on your back with your feet wide apart and flat on the ground, rest your head on the floor and clasp your hands behind your head. Now dig your back into the floor and slowly lift your hips and hold for 5 counts. This one's a good tension reliever, so take it slowly. Begin the side circle. Lie with your hands clasped behind your head, with your legs straight up. Your head may be up or down for comfort. Swing your right leg in a wide circle, then circle the left leg. Side circle each leg 15 to 20 times, alternating right and left. That's it. Swing that leg out wide. This exercise is an excellent toner for the muscles that crisscross the stomach. That's it, and relax. Lie with your right leg bent in front, the left leg up, and your hands behind your head. Slowly lower your left leg. Just as it nears the other leg, swing your left leg out to the side. Then swing it back toward the center, returning to the starting position. Continue to the count of 8 with each leg. That's it, slowly now. And now the other leg. Don't press yourself, pace yourself. start by kneeling on your hands and knees with your head up. Pull your right knee in toward your chest. Clasp it with your right hand and press your head down toward your knee. Hold this position for a count of five. Now, repeat with the left knee. Complete three with each leg. You might have a problem with balance here, but keep trying, you'll get it. This exercise not only relieves stress on the back, but strengthens it as well. Hold that knee. Hold steady now. That's it. This concludes today's workout. The following section contains guidelines and advice. We recommend that while you participate in the Flatten Your Stomach program, that you review this section periodically for advice and general guidelines. Make exercise a part of your daily routine. Establish a set time, night or day, that's convenient for you, and do your best to stick to it. Always try to wear comfortable, non-binding clothing and shoes or sneakers with good support and padding to absorb shock and prevent injuries to the ankles and legs. Eat moderately before and after exercising. Exercising on a full stomach may cause nausea and dizziness. And if you feel dizzy or nauseous, stop exercising immediately. Remember, your body's metabolism will continue to work in high gear for hours after exercising. You'll notice that in some exercises, you're advised to keep your foot flat out rather than pointed. This will condition and lengthen the hamstring muscles in the backs of the legs. The additional weight created by the flat foot also forces the stomach muscles to work harder. And that's what this program is all about, flattening that stomach. The heart, like any other muscle, will become stronger when made to work harder. During an active exercise session, your heartbeat will increase to between 70 and 85% of its maximum rate. After the aerobic run, make a note of your pulse rate, then check this heart rate chart to see if your heart rate is within the target range for your age group. So no matter what shape you're in now, or what age you are, you can change your life, your look, and your attitude through daily exercise. Don't stop now. You're already on your way.